Thank you. This is Apollo Control. It's 72 hours, 7 minutes. Apollo 11 is 9,761 nautical miles from the moon. Velocity, 4,217 feet per second. Weight, 96,012 pounds.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. How do you read? Over.
Okay, we went to the high gain. Looks like you're having a little trouble getting signal strength there.
Roger, we missed an Omni switch there. Over.
Right, on the secondary loop check, when we went to flow on the secondary radiators, the quantity dropped from 40% down to 36 in the first 10 seconds and then stabilized at 36 for the remainder of the 30 seconds.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We believe that's normal system operation. The radiators are expected to be very cold right now, and apparently the decrease you saw was due to contraction in the fluid. Over.
Okay, we'll go ahead with the procedure just as if there were no decrease in accumulator quantity, right?
Roger, press on.
Houston, the secondary radiator flow check is complete and
satisfactory.
Houston, Roger out. And that's a good deal because we don't have to have any meetings about whether we're going to do it or don't do it anymore.
That's for sure.
That was a Mike Collins comment.
Flight director says ouch.
No, no ouch intended. I enjoyed every one of those meetings.
I-11, this is Houston. I have your Paracynthian Plus 2 pad, P30 format, when you're ready to copy.
Houston, Apollo 11, ready to copy Paris and VM Plus 2.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Paracynthian plus 2 hours, pad, SPS GNN, 62710, plus 098, minus 019er. GET ignition, 07746-2248. Delta VX, 981, plus 32148, minus 00455, minus 10377, roll NA, pitch 307, and the remainder of the pad is NA. GDC align stars, Vega and Deneb, roll 243. 183012. No ullage. Remarks. Assumes landing site reps mat and docked. Over.
Roger, SPS GNN 62710 plus 09R8. Minus 019er 07746-2248 plus 32148 minus 00455 minus 10377 NA 307 Vega and Deneb 243-183-012 no ullage landing site rest mat docked and then you haven't change in the LEM weight, over.
No change in the LEMs in the LEM weight, and read back is correct, Ed. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger, we're having difficulty getting commands into the spacecraft. We'd like you to cycle your up telemetry switch to command reset and off and then back to normal. Over.
Okay, we'll do it. We have you on high gain right now. You want us to switch over to Army?
Negative. We'd like to stay on the high gain if we can. Over.
Okay.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, we'd like you to switch to Omni Delta as we show you approximate the scan limit of the high gain antenna. We will then command Omni Delta down here after you advise us you've switched. And then you can select Bravo on board, and we'll be back in the Omni antenna commanding business, over. Evan Houston, you can go ahead and select Omni Bravo on board now.
You have it.
Roger out. Apollo 11, this is Houston. If you have a minute or so free, we can read you up the morning news here.
Go right ahead. Let's hear it.
Roger, hot from the wires of the MSC Public Affairs Office, especially prepared for the crew of Apollo 11.
Okay, first off, looks like it's going to be impossible to get away from the fact that you guys are dominating all the news back here on Earth. Even Pravda in Russia is headlining the mission and calls Neil the czar of the ship. I think maybe they got the wrong mission.
West Germany has declared Monday to be Apollo Day. School children in Bavaria have been given the day off. Post office clerks have been encouraged to bring radios to work, and Frankfurt is installing TV sets in public places.
BBC in London is considering a special radio alarm system to call people to their TV sets in case there's a change in the EVA time on the moon.
And in Italy, Pope Paul VI has arranged for a special color TV circuit at his summer residence in order to watch you, even though Italian television is still black and white.
Back here in Houston, your three wives and children got together for lunch yesterday at Buzz's house. According to Pat, it turned out to be a gab fest. The children swam and did some high jumping over Buzz's bamboo pole.
In Moscow, space engineer Anatol Koritsky was quoted by TASS as saying that Luna 15 could accomplish everything that had been done by earlier Luna spacecraft. This was taken by the press to mean Luna 15 could investigate the gravitational fields, photograph the moon, and go down to the surface to scoop up a bit for analysis.
Even the kids at camp got in the news when Mike Jr. was quoted as replying, yeah, when somebody asked him if his daddy was going to be in history. Then after a short pause, he asked, what is history? In Washington, President Nixon is planning to use his executive power to streamline the Interstate Commerce Commission. According to industry sources, it was reported Nixon would trim the commission from 11 to 7 members by not making new appointments.
And the big news around Houston today concerns the Astros. In the sports world, the Houston Astros rallied in the ninth inning at Cincinnati to dump the Reds 7-4. Going into the ninth, however, things looked pretty bleak. The Astros were trailing 4-3. Then with one out, Jesus Alou stroked a single to the right field. John Edwards hit another single to right, and Sandy Valdespino hit a double to bring in the tying run. Julio Gauthier was walked, and Joe Morgan dropped a bunt for the game-winning play. A wild throw to the plate allowed another run to score. Then a sacrifice fly by Dennis Menke brought in the final run. They really came through in the ninth.
Another game's in the National
League.
Yeah,
those Astros really been catching those flies since they put a roof on the stadium.
Good work. In other games in the National League, New York beat Montreal 5-2, Pittsburgh beat St. Louis 4-1, and Atlanta over San Diego in the first game of a doubleheader 6-2.
In the American League, Detroit beat Cleveland 4-0, New York trounced Washington 5-0, Boston out-hit Baltimore to score 6 runs to the Orioles 2, and Chicago beat Kansas City 6-1.
Okay, in golf world, Tommy Jacobs, an infrequent competitor in recent years, took the lead in the Philadelphia Golf Classic yesterday. His second round score was 139.
You might be interested in knowing, since you are already on the way, that a Houston astrologer, Ruby Graham, says that all the signs are right for your trip to the moon. She says that Neil is clever, Mike has good judgment, and Buzz can work out intricate problems. She also says Neil tends to see the world through rose-colored glasses, but he is always ready to help the afflicted or distressed. Neil, you are also supposed to have, quote, intuition that enables you to interpret life with feeling, unquote. Buzz is to be very sociable and cannot bear to be alone, in addition to having excellent critical ability. Since she didn't know at what hour Mike was born, she has decided that he either has the same attributes as Neil, or he is inventive with an unconventional attitude that might seem eccentric to the unimaginative.
And last but not least.
Ruby Graham, an astrologer here in Houston. Now we checked with flight operations for all the signs for the mission, and then we of course had to make sure that everything was really all set. Omnis, can you stand by for about 2 minutes?
Radio check.
11, Houston, go ahead.
Roger, you got out after Tommy Jacobson. I guess we got into antenna switching problems.
Okay, following Tommy Jacobs, we have the hot smoking word from a local Houston astrologer, the name of Ruby Graham. She says that all the signs are right for your trip to the moon. Neil is clever, Mike has good judgment, and Buzz can work out intricate problems. She also says Neil tends to see the world through rose-colored glasses, but is always ready to help the afflicted or distressed. Neil, you're also supposed to have, quote, intuition that enables you to interpret life with feeling, unquote. Buzz is supposed to be very sociable and cannot bear to be alone, in addition to having excellent critical ability. Since she didn't know at what hour Mike was born, she's decided he either has the same attributes as Neil, or that he is inventive with an unconventional attitude that might seem eccentric to the imaginative. And that's 30 for today. Over.
Well, thank you much there, Bruce and Fred Show. We appreciate that.
Roger.
That was Fred Hayes alternating with Bruce McCandless on that newscast.
Did you hear our comment about the Astros?
The one about the roof?
Yep.
Hey, Mike, the game was at Cincinnati there, and we think that they're still using Crosley Field up there. I don't believe it has a roof on it.
You got him on that one.
Right.
They're just getting to be a good team in the clinch.
They certainly seem to be.
Well, if they can do that well without a roof, think of what they're going to do with a roof.
Roger out.
We're trying. An old Oiler fan is trying to comment on an alien game. You tell Michael Jr. history or no history, he better behave himself.
Roger, we'll pass that along, Mike.
This is Apollo Control at 72 hours 45 minutes. Apollo 11 is now 8,188 nautical miles from the moon, approaching at a velocity of 4,324 feet per second.
Apollo 11 Houston, if it's convenient with you, we have an LOI 1 pad that we can pass up to you now, over.
Stand by. Houston Apollo 11, the next time we pass through roll zero, we're going to stop PTC, and that'll give us a 90 degrees pitch. Now, I understand you want us to move from 90 degrees pitch to 0 degrees pitch for the platform align option one. Is that affirmative?
Stand by, please.
We're ready to copy on the LOI 1.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. When you stop at zero roll, you'll be in approximately 90 pitch, zero yaw, zero roll. We'd like you to run the first P-52, that is the P-52 option 3, from that attitude. Then we'll uplink you a new reps mat, either before or while you're maneuvering, to 000. Then you can torque the platform around and run the second reps mat over. Run the second P-52 over.
Okay.
And I copied you're ready for the LOI 1 pad, over.
Go ahead.
LOI 1, SPS, GNN, 62710 plus 0908. Minus 019er. GET ignition 075 49er 4965. Minus 288 897. Minus 039er 44. Minus 00686. Roll 358. Pitch 226. 347 0169er 2 plus 00610 29er 173 602 29er 108 section star 31 1066 358. The remainder of the pad is NA. GDC align Vega and Deneb. 243-183-012. No ullage. The horizon will be visible just below the upper edge of the hatch window 2 minutes prior to the LOI burn. It will not be visible in the rendezvous window on the left-hand side. LOS at 75 hours. 41 minutes, 23 seconds. AOS at 76, 15, 29er. AOS without the LOI burn, 76, 05, 30. The values which you would see on noun 42 prior to LOI burn are HA plus 431.3, HP minus 128.2. Read back over.
Roger, LOI 1, SPS GMN, 627.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, apparently we missed getting your onboard readouts on Battery Charlie and Pyro Batteries Alpha and Bravo last night. I wonder if you could give us some fresh numbers, over.
You got the readings now?
Yes, please. If it's convenient for you.
Okay, all three of them are still 37.1.
Roger, 37.1 cubed, Doug.
This is Apollo Control at 73 hours, 6 minutes. Apollo 11's distance from the moon is now 7,331 nautical miles. Velocity, 4,399 feet per second. The ignition time passed up to the crew on this pad is 4 minutes, 39 seconds earlier than the LOI-1 time published in the flight plan prior to liftoff. This means that all lunar events will move forward from the published flight plan times by this amount of time, 4 minutes 39 seconds. This time will be made up during the trans-Earth coast, and splash should occur at the flight plan time. This is Mission Control, Houston.
Houston, Apollo 11, the P-52 option 3 is complete. We're maneuvering to 000.
Roger, we observe you maneuvering, and we'll have some uplinks for you in a couple minutes here.
Okay.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We observe you in Foo. If you'll give us accept, we'll start our uplinks.
You got it, Houston.
Roger out. Thank you. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
Roger, we're on low bit rate at the present time, so it's going to take us a little bit longer than normal to get this stuff up to you, over.
I guess we're in no rush.
Okay, we're here if you're there.
The view of the moon that we've been having recently is really spectacular. It fills about three quarters of the hatch window, and of course we can see the entire circumference, even though part of it is in complete shadow and part of it's in Earthshine. It's a view worth the price of the trip.
Well, there are a lot of us down here that would be willing to come along.
That was Neil Armstrong.
I hope you get your turn in soon. One of these days we'll be able to bring the whole bunker along, I hope. Save a lot of antenna switches.
Say again, 11.
One of these days we can bring the whole bunker along, and then that'll save a lot of antenna switches.
That's Charlie.
The Moker is the mission operations control room. It's the control center here.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
11, this is Houston, we're showing you...
Bizarre is brushing his teeth, so I'm filling in for him.
Say again, please.
I said Bizarre is brushing his teeth, so I'm filling in for him. What can we do for you?
Roger, well, if you don't get in the way of Bizarre while he's brushing his teeth, we'd like you to bring up the primary accumulator quantity a little bit. We're showing the quantity now at 20.6% on PM. Seems to have gone down a bit since you've gone into the shadow. We'd like it serviced to bring the quantity up to between 30 and 40%, preferably 35%, over.
Okay.
The computer is yours, 11. The loads are in and verified. You can go back to block.
We're in block.
11, this is Houston. On the basis of your last P-52 alignment, the platform looks like it's indeed performing very well. No problems there, no updates required, and no PIPA bias update is required either. Over.
Sounds good.
This is Apollo Control at 73 hours, 25 minutes. Apollo 11 is 6,522 nautical miles away from the moon, approaching it at a velocity of 4,483 feet per second.
Houston, Apollo 11, radio check.
11, this is Houston, loud and clear, over.
Okay, just checking. You want high gain?
Roger, if you can give it to us.
Okay.
Houston,
Apollo 11, how do you read on the high gain?
Loud and clear on the high gain.
Same here. We've completed P-52 option 1.
Roger, we've been looking over your shoulder by TM.
Glad to have you.
Thank you.
Houston, Apollo 11, standing by to copy TTI 1 and TTI 4.
Oh, Roger, I've got the 1 and 4 pads here right now. I'll be ready to read them up to you in just a second. Eleven, this is Houston. I'm ready with the TEI 1 and 4 pads. Over.
Ready to copy.
Roger, TEI 1, SPS GNN, 38658, minus 054, plus 065. TIG? 078-02-0345 plus 29er-180 plus 03779er minus 01325 roll NA pitch 041 the balance of the pad is NA ullage 2 jets 19 seconds TEI 4 pad, SPS GNN, 38658, minus 054, plus 065, TIG 084, 29er, 5059er, plus 31373. Plus 03760 minus 00968 roll NA pitch 034 rest of the pad is NA ullage 2 jets 19er seconds both of these pads are for an undocked maneuver TEI plus 4 pad assumes no LOI 2 over. Make that TEI 4 pad, assumes no LOI 2.
Roger, TEI 1, SPS GNN, 38658, minus 054, plus 065, 078, 02. 0345 plus 29er 180 plus 03779er minus 01325 roll NA pitch 041 2 jet 19 seconds undocked TEI 4 38658 minus 054 plus 065 084, 29er, 5059er, plus 31373, plus 03760, minus 00968, roll NA pitch 034, 2 jet 19 seconds, undocked, assumes no LOI 2.
11, this is Houston.
11, over.
11, this is Houston, read back correct, out.
That was Buzz Aldrin with the readback of that information, which was for contingency trans-earth injection burns. If if required, shortly after lunar orbit insertion.
And this is Houston, over.
Roger, go ahead, Houston.
Roger, at GET of 7430, we'd like you to cycle the fans in all four cryo tanks and position the heaters in all four cryo tanks to the auto position. We're doing this in advance of LOI in order to ensure that you don't have any destratification as a result of the burn, which might result in giving you a master caution and warning during the burn. Over.
Okay, with that 7430, you want us to cycle the heaters and cycle the fans and turn all the heaters on?
All the heaters to auto, cycle the fans at 7430 about 25 minutes from now. Over.
Okay.
This is Apollo Control at 74 hours, 8 minutes. Apollo 11 is 4,625 nautical miles away from the moon. Velocity 4,765 feet per second. We're 1 hour 32 minutes away from loss of signal as Apollo 11 goes behind the moon, and we're about 1 hour 41 minutes away from the LOI number one burn.
We'll be right back.
This is Apollo Control at 74 hours, 32 minutes. Apollo 11 is traveling at a velocity of 3,000. Stand by. We've got a static display here.
This is Houston, radio check, over.
Houston 11.
Roger, loud and clear now.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Apparently, this is not a very good Omni attitude for you. We're ready to start our TVC check.
This is Houston. We're ready, except that we'd like to get the high gain antenna prior to this test, over.
Can you give us a couple of pointing angles?
Roger, from an attitude with 60 degrees roll around to an attitude of roll 058 inertial, it would be pitch plus 30 and yaw 270 on the high gain antenna.
Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Do you read? Over.
Roger, loud and clear.
Roger, we're reading you, weak but clear.
Roger, we put our roll for a MSN track in the wrong sign. Going to continue rolling around until we get high gain here. And we'll delete the pitch. It was scheduled after the TVC check.
Say again, please, 11.
Roger. We put the wrong sign
Roger.
In for the roll correction to get MSN high gain, and we're continuing rolling around to get the proper attitude for high gain at this time. We will delete the pitch maneuver that was scheduled subsequent to the TV check since we already have those pictures.
Roger, we copy. And and we recommend that you go ahead and complete your TVC test on board. If you have problems, we'll talk to you when you get around further into the high gain antenna attitude. Over.
Roger. Houston, how you read on high gain?
Oh, loud and clear on high gain 11.
Roger, we're proceeding.
Roger.
Control.